Before beginning with the video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to stay updated of my latest videos. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and today I'll be showing you the top 5 best ways to use the Morph Transition in PowerPoint 2019. Before beginning with that, let me acquaint you with some basics of the Morph Transition. So the transition works as follows. Like here I have inserted this image and I duplicate the slide by right clicking and then choosing duplicate slide, or else you can use the shortcut keys Ctrl plus D. And in this next slide, I'll just reposition my image and apply the Morph Transition from the Transitions tab. And you can see that the image gets animated in this way. So this can work with any object or text, and the Morph Transition is based upon the following. Duplicating the slide by pressing Ctrl plus D and then repositioning the elements. So we are done with the basics and let's quickly jump into the tutorial. So this is the kind of effect which we will be creating using the Morph Transition. This is actually a beautiful way to present your images in the slide. You can see that the images are coming and entering the slide one by one, and then the final image expands to the whole of the slide. And can you observe that how smoothly the images are moving across the slide? This animation effect has been possible only because of the Morph Transition, and let us quickly start with a tutorial to create this effect. First of all, insert 4 images in your slide. Guys, do take care that all the images should be of same size and should be completely overlapping with each other. If not, then you can resize the images or even crop the unnecessary parts to do the same. So after you observe that the images are now completely overlapping with each other, select all the images by pressing Ctrl plus A and adjust the size of the images such that there should be some space on the left side of the slide like this. You can now separate all of these images. Actually, this first slide is only our reference slide, and we will be creating a new slide to start with the animation effect. Insert first image from your reference slide and keep it outside of the slide at the right hand side. Then duplicate the slide by pressing Ctrl plus D and move this image inside the slide to its original position. Now you guys must have understood that when I will apply Morph Transition to the slide, the image will seem to enter the slide from the right hand side. And in the very same slide, insert your second image from the reference slide and in a similar manner place it outside the slide after ensuring that the two images are completely overlapping with each other. You can also use the shift key while moving the image so that it moves in a straight direction. Now again duplicate the slide and reposition all the elements. So here I will make the entrance of our second image to our slide. Let me send it to back, and then I will make the first image smaller and position it to the top left corner of the slide. And using the same process, I will insert the third image into the slide and place it outside of the slide. Again, do note that you need to place the image in the same proportion and in the same direction and alignment so that there is uniformity in the animation. So move the image out of the slide while holding the shift key. Now again duplicate the slide and follow the same process for the last image. Enter the third image in the slide, make second image smaller and place it at the middle left of the slide, and place the final image outside the slide. So now duplicate the slide, enter the final image and place the third image at the bottom left corner of the slide. Also note that when I am making the images smaller, I am again ensuring that the images are of same size and in same alignment with each other. Actually, PowerPoint software automatically shows me the grid lines to do the same. And finally, I will duplicate the slide and place all the other images outside the slide at the left hand side and fill the whole slide with this image only. And now you can delete the reference slide and finally apply Morph Transition effect to all the slides. So this is how we create this beautiful picture animation effect just by repositioning the images and applying the morph transition to the slides. Earlier, when morph transition was not there, we had to, you know, apply the motion path effects and the grow or shrink effect to the images to create this effect. But that was really, really very time consuming process, you know. So this is a very simple yet useful animation effect which even beginners can create very, very easily. The next effect which we would be creating using the morph transition is the infographic text animation effect. Let me show you a glimpse of this effect. So you can see that the text peeps in from within the slide. And then there is a frame which is highlighting our text. Again, this is all based upon repositioning of the elements, so let's create this effect from scratch. First of all, insert a rectangular shape in the slide from which our text will be moving inwards. Then type in the text and place it near that rectangular bar. And now the most important step. We need to insert a covering element that would cover our text. Let me explain it to you. For example, here I will insert a rectangle that should cover my text and make sure that the box is of the same color as that of the background and also its border should touch the rectangle bar. So obviously this would only work if your slide has some solid color as a background and not any picture or graphics background. Also remove the shape outline. So now the shape has completely merged with the background and you can see that it is also able to hide my text. So I'm ready with all my elements in the slide and now it's time to reposition them. So duplicate the slide, place the text behind this white box and that's it. Just drag the slide above the first one and apply the morph transition. So it took hardly any 2 minutes to create this professional text infographic animation effect, which was earlier only possible to create in softwares like Adobe After Effects. Also, you can customize it and have fun with this effect. Like I'll duplicate this slide and select this rectangle bar and in the format options, I will reduce the height and the width of this rectangle bar to 0. So what happens that when I apply the morph transition and change the duration of the transition, the rectangle bar appears and then the text moves in. So in this way, you can try some other creative customizations to this animation effect. Like here I have inserted another shape in the slide and transformed it to create this kind of animation. So there are n number of creative things that you can try with this effect and I will be uploading a separate video for this regarding the kinetic typography in PowerPoint 2019 where I'll be using the morph transition and these kinds of effects to create a kinetic typography video. So do subscribe my channel and stay tuned for my further uploads. The next animation effect is the toggle button animation effect. Again, this is a very popular animation effect and I will show you how you can easily create it using the morph transition in the PowerPoint software. First, we need to create the shape for this toggle button. So let's begin by inserting a rectangle in our slide. Let me change the shape color and remove the shape outline. Now insert a circle in your slide such that the diameter of the circle should be equal to the length of the rectangle. You can see that PowerPoint automatically shows you the grid lines to properly adjust the circle. Then copy paste this circle and place it on the other side of the shape. Select all the three shapes, hit the format tab and under the merge shapes, select union. So now all the three shapes have been combined to just one shape. And now paste the circle one more time, which will act as a button in this shape. Let me change its color. Place it to the extreme left of the shape. Also, let's change the background color to make it look more dramatic. Now duplicate the slide by pressing Ctrl plus D and just reposition the elements. First, I will change the color scheme of the slide from black to blue and change all the colors accordingly. Then I will shift the button to the extreme right of the shape and apply the morph transition to the slide. So here we go. This is how we create a toggle button animation using the Morph Transition in the PowerPoint software. The next best way to use the Morph Transition in PowerPoint is to create flat transitions. Guys, this is really a very useful technique to beautifully change the slide. And to create this transition, zoom out of the slide a little bit and insert a rectangle shape which should be placed outside of the slide. Copy paste this rectangle shape and create 4 such rectangle shapes. Change the colors of all the rectangles and remove the shape outline. Now duplicate the slide and reposition all the rectangle shapes to cover the whole slide as shown. Now here comes the most important step of this effect. Copy all these rectangle shapes from the slide and paste it to above our next slide, which is to appear after the transition ends. If you somehow miss this step, the transition would not work properly, so please take care of this step. Now duplicate this very slide, the one which is to appear after the transition, and reposition the shapes to move them out of the slide. And now it's time to apply the morph transition to the slides. Please closely observe how I am applying the morph transition to different slides. Do not apply the transition to this middle one slide, the second one on which we had placed the rectangle shapes. Also, choose this slide to move after 0 seconds and not on mouse click. For this slide, set the duration of transition to 1 second and again choose it to change after 0 seconds. And for this slide, I will keep the duration to 1 second. Let's see what we have achieved so far. Perfect. Also, you can apply this transition by using the diagonal rectangle boxes. This technique is also very much similar to the previous one. Just you need to reposition the boxes in a diagonal manner. And now the final animation effect which we are going to create using the morph transition is the pan and zoom effect. Very simple, very effective. And this is really very useful technique to present your pictures. By this time, after watching all the previous effects, this should seem very simple to you and you should be able to create this effect by yourself just by repositioning the image and applying the morph transition. However, I'll be showing you in this video to create that. Just insert your image and zoom it to the point you want. You can see how the image looks in the slide viewer. You can take the help of the slide viewer. And now simply duplicate the slide and apply the morph transition, as simple as that. So guys, this was all about the 5 best animations using the morph transition in PowerPoint 2019. And do remember that there is a lot of scope to add variations in all of these animation techniques, and maybe you can try to create some new ones by learning the ones shown in the video. So keep trying something different and something new. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.